Gideon, Barak, Samson and Jephthah, by faith. And what more shall I say? For the time would fail me to tell of Gideon and Barak and Samson and Jephthah. Hebrews 11 verse 32. So much has been noted in these chronicles of faith concerning the extensive consequences that appear as faith accesses grace. As our present verse implies, days and pages seem too short to also relate the testimonies of Gideon, Barak, Samson and Jephthah, who many might view as unlikely examples of living by faith. In Gideon, God was calling an unlikely leader as his instrument for delivering his people. His humble reply was, "O my Lord, how can I save Israel? I am the least in my father's house," Judges 6 verse 15. The Lord's promise was, "Surely I will be with you, and you shall defeat the Midianites," Judges 6 verse 16. When 32,000 Israelites rallied for battle, see Judges 7 verse 3, God diminished Gideon's army to an unimpressive, outnumbered 300. Then the Lord said to Gideon, "By the 300 men who lapped I will save you," Judges 7 verse 7. Gideon went forth by faith, and the Lord was faithful to his word. When the 300 blew the trumpets, the Lord set every man's sword against his companion, and the army fled, Judges 7 verse 22. Again, in Barak, another unlikely leader was selected by the Lord. First, he would not go forth to battle unless the prophetess Deborah accompanied him, and Barak said to her, "If you will go with me, then I will go, but if you will not go with me, I will not go," Judges 4 verse 8. Also, his godless opponent was actually defeated by another woman. Sisera had fled away on foot to the tent of Jael, the wife of Heber. Then Jael took a tent peg and took a hammer in her hand, and drove the peg into his temple, for he was fast asleep and weary. So, he died, Judges 4 verse 17, Judges 4 verse 21. In Samson, we have another unexpected example of faith. Although he did many mighty exploits, he often proved to be a vain and foolish man, especially concerning women. Yet, in his death, he won his greatest victory of all. O Lord God, remember me, I pray. Strengthen me, I pray, just this once, O God. So, the dead that he killed at his death were more than he had killed in his life, Judges 16 verse 28, Judges 16 verse 30. In Jephthah, we have one more unlikely example of faith. He was the son of a harlot, Judges 11 verse 1. He made what appeared to be an unwise vow, Judges 11 verse 1. Still, on occasion, his trust in the Lord was evident. Then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jephthah, and the Lord delivered them into his hands, Judges 11 verse 29, Judges 11 verse 32. Let us pray. Lord God of the unlikely servant, I thank you for these testimonies of those likely to be overlooked by many. Yet, at various times and in many situations, their faith in you was demonstrated. Lord, I am encouraged that you are not looking for the spectacular performer or the capable achiever. You are looking for people who will trust in you as you deal with their shortcomings. I praise you, Lord, for such loving kindness. Amen.